Hello guys, we have implemented class complex in the last video and I have written one statement over there which is C3 equals to C1 plus C2, where C1, C2, C3 are the objects of class complex. So when I compile the code, then this statement was throwing error because plus operator was not overloaded for class complex. That means compiler is not understanding what is the addition of objects of class complex. So I told you that to overcome that error, we need to overload operator plus. So C1 object was declared something like this, 1020, and C2 object was declared as 1224. Suppose this is inside the main function. Then we'll see how to overload plus operator or how to overload any operator. Now there are three types of operator in C language or C++ language: unary, binary and ternary. So out of them, ternary operator we cannot overload. So only operators that we can overload is unary and binary. So in C++ there are four operators which we cannot overload. So first one is ternary, then size of is there, then scope resolution is there and dot is there. So these four operators we cannot overload. So unary and binary operators we can overload apart from these operators. So we will see how to overload them. Now we should understand how this statement is treated by the compiler. Now plus is a binary operator. So when I say C1 plus C2, this statement is treated by a compiler as function call C1 dot operator plus, and C2 will be argument to the function. So name of the function will be operator plus. So in case of any binary operator, first object which is onto the left hand side of the function is taken as function invoking object. So C1 dot, then operator is a keyword, and after that I will give the operator which I am using. So operator plus here, and inside the parenthesis other object is passed. So this statement is resolved something like this, or any binary operator. If I say C1 minus C2, then it will be treated as C1 dot operator minus, and I will pass C2. So this is as a member function. Again, there are two ways to resolve the function calls, one as a member function and other as a global function. So as of now, we are going for member function, or we will resolve function call as member function as far as possible. There are some exceptional cases when we need to go for a global function. We will see them later, but as of now, member functions. Now let's consider unary operator. So suppose I write some statement like C4 equals to minus C1. So now in this case, minus is unary operator. So when I say minus C1, only one object is there, and that object is taken as function invoking object. So this statement will be treated by the compiler as C1 dot operator minus, and empty parenthesis I will give. So this statement will be treated something like this. So for unary operators, only one object which is taken as function invoking object, and for binary operators, left hand side will be function invoking, right hand side will be explicitly passed object. So let's implement few operators with respect to class complex. So I have taken two objects of complex class C1 and C2. C1 is 10 plus 20i and C2 is 12 plus 24i. And I am saying C3 equals to C1 plus C2. So name of the file is complex.cpp. So if I compile this, g++ complex.cpp hyphen o and say executable is complex. So it is throwing an error, no match for operator plus. So I told you the reason. I need to overload operator plus to avoid this error. So this function call is resolved as C3 equals to C1 dot operator plus inside parenthesis C2. So if I write this operator plus function in class complex, then it will solve the issue. So I will add this operator plus function in my class complex. So how will be the signature for operator plus? Now operator plus will add two complex numbers. So result is also a complex number. So return type will be complex because that result I am assigning to C3. So
I will mention the declaration here. Return type is complex. Then name of the function is operator plus, and it is taking argument of complex type only, since I am passing the object of complex class. So here it will be complex ampersand. Now let me write the definition. So return type is complex, class name is complex, scope resolution, name of the function is operator plus, and argument is complex ampersand C. As far as possible, try to receive the argument by reference, because if I pass the argument by reference, there won't be any call to copy constructor, because we know that in call by value copy constructor is called, and in call by reference copy constructor is not called. So it is advisable that wherever possible you take it by reference. Now how to write a definition? C1 object is passed using this pointer, and C2 object is passed explicitly. So suppose I declare one more object here, which is temp object, which will store the result of addition of C1 and C2, then temp.real equals to C1's real plus C2's real. So C1 real means this arrow real, or I will simply write real, plus C2 is received inside C object, so C.real. Then temp.imaginary equals to img plus C.img. So this will add the C1 and C2, and it will store the result into temp. And after that I will say return temp, which is received inside the C3 object. So if I want to display the addition, I will say C3.display. Now let me compile and check whether it is running. So it is showing 22 plus 44 i, 12 plus 10 22 24 plus 20 44. So answer is correct. It is adding the two complex numbers C1 and C2. So if you debug this code, you will see that then you will see that at this statement C3 equals to C1 plus C2, if I press S step into, then it is going inside the operator plus function that we have written. So this is how plus operator is overloaded. In the further videos, we will overload few more operators. So please subscribe to my channel. I will see you again in the next video.